Okay, so the syntax of writing, we are discussing about the creation of data frame data structure. The first one, it is empty data frame data structure creation. For creating empty data frame data structure, which statement is used, Ashish? For creating empty data frame data structure,
mode.spd.
After that,
open bracket, close bracket.
After import pandas spd, you want to write one more statement, one more line.
Dot series.
We are dealing with data frame. Basil, which is the statement used for creating empty data frame, Basil? Empty data frame. Meenakshi?
Yes, ma'am.
Which is the
DF is equal to P dot data frame empty data.
Correct, Meenakshi. DF is equal to, DF is the data frame's name. Data frame name, it is DF. DF is equal to PD dot data frame empty bracket. This is the statement for creating empty data frame. Is it clear, Ashish? Ashish?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, next is creation of data frame data structure using some values. For that, the syntax is, first write the statement import pandas as pd. After that, pd dot data frame within bracket, you can use three attributes or three values. First one, it is data. Second one, first one, it is data. Second one, it is index. Third one, it is column. What is index? Is it row or column? Raina, what is index? Index is row. Okay. The other name for index, it is row name, row value. Index name means row name. Index means row value. So, index is for representing row name. Okay, so column is used to represent the column heading. Then data takes data. What is data? Data means the value. The case of series, data value and index value is there. Same way, data value is known as data here. Takes various forms like series, list, constants or scalar values, dictionary and another data frame. Okay. So, data in the data frame data structure means either we can use a series for representing data, or we can use a list for representing data. We can use constant or scalar value. Give one example for constant or scalar value, Grishma. Give an example for constant or scalar value.
Yes, ma'am.
Give an example for constant or scalar value.
Example, when 15 is the data value for all.
Yes, 15, 50, 25, all these values are scalar values or constant values. Okay, so data means some value in that data frame data structure. We can use a series as data, or we can use list as data, or we can use constant or scalar value like 55. 65 data, or we can use dictionary as data, or another data frame also we can use as data. Okay, so that is data. Then index. Index specifies index or row labels to be used for resulting frame. Index means it is the name of row that is used in the data frame. Name of row that is used in the data frame. Then column specifies column labels, it is column headings. So the three values that is included in data frame creation. It is data, index and column. Okay, so data means the values inside that data frame data structure, that is data. Then index means it is the row name given for each and every row in the data frame data structure. Then column is the column name of the data frame data structure. Then this index and column is optional. If you are not giving index and column, what is the value of, what is the name of index in a data frame data structure? Meghna, if I want to create a data frame data structure, that is pd.data, only data is there, there is no index and no column, only data. Then what is the index value and column value for that data frame data structure? Yes, it is. Index value is starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, just like that. Column value is also 0, 1, 2, 3, just like that. Okay. So, if there is no index value and column value, when we are creating a data frame data structure, the data frame data structure use default index value and column value. The default index and column value, it is starting from 0 to how many rows? That is the number. How many rows? Then number of rows minus 1. That is 0 to number of rows minus 1. The case of column also. 0 to number of columns 1. So, for creating a data frame data structure, the syntax is, first we want to import the pandas from the Python library. After that, the statement is pd. Here it is, first you want to write the name of that data frame data structure. So here the name, it is df. So df is equal to pd dot data frame within bracket, three values are there, but it is not compulsory. This index and column, it is optional. You must use this data value, otherwise the data frame data structure is a empty data frame. Okay, if you are using empty bracket, that means it is for the empty data frame data structure. So if you want to include some values, the statement is just like that, pd dot data frame within bracket write data, that index and column is optional. So if the index and column is optional, then the interpreter will take the default index name and column name. Okay, Anthony, which one is the default index name and column name? Anthony, Anjo, okay, Anthony. What is the default value of index and column? Anjo, what is the default index and column value?
0, 1, 2,
number of rows minus 1. Then column, it is 0, 2, number of columns minus 1. Okay, so these are the three values related with data frame creation. So this is empty representation. Then write a program. So first write the heading, creating data frame from list. Creating data frame from list. So the question is, write a program to create a data frame using a list. So if you want to create a data frame using list, how we can represent a list, Donna? How we can represent a list? Using square bracket, okay. We can give the values within square bracket, that is list, okay. So first statement for creating data frame, it is same as series, that is import pandas as pd. After that, create a list. I'll give the list name as list1. List1 is the list name which is equal to three values within square bracket. So the content of list1, it is 10, 20 and 30. Okay. So after importing pandas, the next statement it is, I will create one list. The list name it is list1, which is equal to within square bracket give three values. If you want five value, write five value in, between this square bracket, okay. If we need 10 value, just write 10 values within square bracket. So to create a list, use square bracket. Within square bracket give the values, separate the values using comma, okay. So list 1 is equal to 10 comma 20 comma 30. So list means values within square bracket. Then after that, I am using a statement for creating a data frame using this list, okay. Irfan, what is the syntax for creating a data frame? Syntax for creating a data frame, there is no need of saying that import pandas. Write the statement, second statement. Irfan? Irfan? Okay, Hanna? The syntax it is df is equal to pd dot data frame within bracket, three values are there, index comma data comma index comma column, okay. These are the three values included in data frame, okay. So the syntax of creating data frame, it is df is equal to pd dot data frame within round bracket, first write the data, then index, then column, okay. So this is the syntax for creating a data frame. So after creating a list, I want to create a data frame using this list. Okay. To create a data frame using a list, the statement is, first write the data frame name. It is common for all the data frame. If you want to write the name like df1, you just write df1. Okay. Here I am giving df. Df is equal to pd dot. The function name, it is data frame. D and F is capital. So data frame within bracket, I am only giving the data value. The data is enclosed in a list. So the list name, it is list1. So I place the list name here. Okay. The data value is in the list1, is in the list. The name of that list, it is list1. So I write the name of that list, that is list1 here. So df is equal to pd dot data frame within bracket, write the list name. Here the list name, it is list1, okay. So it is list1. Then after that, the print statement is print df, Okay, it is almost same as that of series creation. The only difference, main difference, it is instead of series, our function name for creating data frame, it is data frame. That is the main difference. List, dictionary, almost all the same. So after creating a list, use the statement df is equal to pd dot data frame within bracket. We want to write the values. Where is the value? The values are in this list 1. So write the name of that list. It is list 1. Then how is the output? Evelyn, here there is no index and column. Then first what is the index value for this df, Evelyn? It's not clear, Evelyn. Okay, no problem. Anjo? Anjo? Which is the index value of this df? 0, 1, 2. Okay. Raina? What is the column values? Which are the column values? Raina, is there? No. Okay. Meghna? It's not clear, Meghna. Okay, Vidur?
0.
0. 1. Then the values 0, 1 is there, Vidur?
No,
1 is not there. Only one column is there. Which are the values under this 0, Vidur?
10, 20, 30.
Okay, so the row values are 0, 1, 2. The values inside the list, it is 10, 20, 30. That means 3 rows we needed. So 3 rows, 0 starting from 0. So 0, 1, 2. The values are 10, 20, 30. The column name is also, we are using default column name, that is 0. Okay. Is it clear? So for creating data frame using a list means, first you want to create a list. List 1 is equal to, within square bracket, write the values. After that, use the statement df is equal to pd dot data frame within bracket, write the value list 1. Then print df. The output section include index value and column value. Here there is no index value, so the interpreter will take the default index value. Here the values are 10, 20, 30. That is 3 values are there, 3 rows are there. So it is 0, 1, 2. 3 index value. The values are 10, 20, 30. The column heading, it is also default value. One column is there, so the value, it is 0. Is it clear, Anthony? Amal, is it clear? Then write a program. Write a program to create a data frame. To create a data frame from a list L1, the values are 8.1, 8.2, 8.3, and 8.4. Kamal completed? Read the statements. First unmute Amal. Okay. Import pandas as PD is the first statement. Then second statement Amal.
L1 equal to
values 8.1, 8.2, 8.3, 8.4. Then next statement. Irfan, read the next statement. Irfan, Elvina, read the next statement. Data frame. Ashish, read the output. Ashish, read the output. Meenakshi, read the output. First read the column heading.
Zero.
Then?
Rows are 0, 1, 2, 3.
Values?
Rows are 8.1, 8.2.
Okay. This is the output representation. Okay, you want to write, learn the output representation and also the statements related with the data frame creation. Okay, so this is the program related with creating a data frame using list. Okay, for that first write the import statement. After that, create a list using square bracket. And after that, df is equal to pd.dataframe within bracket, write the list name, it is L1. After that, print df. Okay. Then write the next heading, it is creating a data frame from nested list. What is nested list? Just like nested for, nested while, what is nested list?
Repeated.
That is a list within another list, that is nested list. Okay, a list within another list, nested list. One second. Here this is the nested list representation. D1 is the list name. Within one list, I am using three list. That is nested list. Okay. D1 is the list name. And within one square bracket, I am using three list. That is nested list. A list, one or more list within another list. That is nested list. Okay, so the first list consists of two values, Sraya and 20. Second list it include Ryan and 21. Then third list it is Ram and 21. Okay, so three lists are there, that is placed inside another list, that is nested list. Okay, so using this nested list we can create another data frame. So the statement is df1 is equal to pd.dataframe within bracket, first write the data value. Here I am using column name. In the previous case also we can give column name. Okay, I will give one question after this based on column name and row name. Okay, so first write the statement. DFN is equal to PD dot data frame within bracket D1. D1 is for data value. Here three lists are the data values. That is, first list is for first row. This is for first row. This is for second row. This is for third row. Okay. So within a list we are using three list. The first list is for first row representation, second list is for second row, and third is for third row. Okay. So PD dot data frame D1 is the data value representation, and I am giving column names as columns. As columns is the keyword used for assigning names for each and every column. So column is equal to use another list. First column name it is name, second column name it is age. Okay, here first I am using a nested list. Nested list means a list is placed, one or more list is placed within another list. This is the outer list. Within this outer list I am using three separate list. The first list is for representing first row of data frame, second list is for second row of data frame, and third list is for third row data of data frame. Okay, after that I will just write the statement for creating data frame, that is df1 is equal to pd dot data frame. Within that function we can use three arguments. The first one, it is data. Data is in which variable? It is in d1. Okay, the data is in d1. So first write d1 for data value, and next I am giving names, column names. Column names is represented using columns is equal to within square bracket we have two column, first column, second column. This is the first row, this is the second row, and this is the third row. So this is the first column, this is the second column. Okay, so we need two column names. For that use another list. The square bracket is for list, so columns is the keyword used for assigning name to each and every column. So columns is equal to within square bracket, within single quotes or double quotes you just write name. Name is the first column heading, age is the second column heading, then close this round bracket, then print df1. Then what is the index value here, Donna? Here, what is index value? That is 0, 1, 2, just like that. Okay. So, the output is 0, 1, 2. Column name it is name. After name it is age. So, first row it is Shreya. Age it is Tundi. Second it is Ryan, age it is 21. Third it is Ram, age again 21. Okay, is it clear? Hanna, is it clear? Okay, so this is the creation of data frame using nested list. Nested list means two or more list within another list, that is nested list. For that I am using df1 is equal to pd dot data frame. First write the data value variable name. Here the data values are in d1, so I will write the name d1 here. After that columns is equal to name, age. Name is the first column name and age is the second column name. Okay, write another program, write a program to create a data frame using nested list. A data frame using nested list. The first row content is 1 comma computer science comma 80. Then second row 2 comma IP comma 95. Third row it is 3 comma Hindi comma 85. Okay, so these are the three rows, and give column names as roll number, subject and mark. Roll number. Okay, the first value it is 1 computer science 80, 2 IP 95, 3 Hindi 85. The column names are roll number, subject and mark. Column number, subject and mark. Write the output also. Anjo, Irfan, Ashir, Sana, Anthony, switch on the video. Anjo, switch on the video. Irfan, Ashir, Sana, switch on the video. Irfan, am I audible, Irfan? Ashish, switch on the video, Ashish. Sana, switch on the video. Hanna completed. Okay. And did you read the first statements? First two statements.
Import pandas as PD.
Okay, import pandas as PD. Then next statement.
D1 equal to. Bracket.
Square bracket. Okay. Then.
One more. Square bracket and one. Computer science.
How we write this computer science?
Four.
Single quotes. Okay. because it's a string. Then after that close the first second square bracket. Okay,
now open bracket, square bracket, 2 comma I 3 comma 95, close the bracket, open bracket, 3 comma in the comma I 3 5, close the bracket.
Then one more bracket for closing the first bracket. Okay, Donna, read the next statement.
Then df1 is equal to pd dot data frame.
Data frame.
Bracket d1 comma colon is equal to roll number subject mark.
Which bracket?
Round bracket.
Is it round bracket? The square bracket.
No, square.
Okay, square bracket. Then first one it is roll number.
Subject so right. Mark.
Enclose the roll number within single quotes because it's a string. Okay. Then next it is subject. Subject is also string. So subject within single quotes. Then
mark.
Close the square bracket and also close the round bracket. Okay, close the square bracket and also close the round bracket. Evelyn, next statement. Next statement it is print df. Then read the output, Evelyn.
Column names are roll number, subject and mark. Then index is 0, 1, 2. Then first row is 1, computer science 80. Second row, 2, IP 95. 3, Hindi 85.
Correct, Evelyn. So this is the output of this data frame. Okay, for creating a data frame using nested list, we use one or more list within another list, and another statement is df1 is equal to pd dot data frame within bracket, first write the data value name. Here these are the values. These values are assigned to a variable name d1. So write the variable name here, that is d1 comma. I want to give some column headings. For giving column names or column heading, first use the keyword columns, which is equal to within square bracket. First write roll number, then subject, then mark, and close the square bracket and also close the round bracket. Then print df1. Here also index value is not there, so the index value is default index value starting from 0. Here 3 rows are used, so that is 0, 1, 2. Okay, column heading it is, first column heading it is roll number, second it is subject, third one it is mark. Okay, so today we discuss two main topics, that is creation of data frame using empty series and creation of data frame using list and nested list. Okay, these are the main topics we discussed today. So you just do these programs in compiler, online Python compiler. Okay, and check the errors and correct the error and find the correct output. Okay, use the Python compiler for executing this program. Do it in the compiler and find out the errors and correct the error. If you need any help, you just message me. Okay, we'll just take the attendance, because in term 1 we need